God hates. God hates people who hate his people. Plain and simple. Plain and simple. And so do I. And it took me a while to come around to that, but so do I. Because, I'm not supposed to have hatred in my heart. The Bible tells me there's a time for love and there's a time for hate. When you start killing my brothers, it's time for hate, brother. You just open the door. You let it in, not me. You kill my brother. And I'm supposed to let that slide. What if you come over here and kill one of my brothers? I got two brothers. Somebody to pay for. One country in Africa. One. Oh, there's a bunch of Muslims over there killing people. Why don't newspapers say that? If it was Christians, they'd say it. If it was Jews, they'd like to say the Jews are killing the Palestinians, boy. But they leave out the part, but the Palestinians begged for the last 20 years. And the Jews had more patience than any other country on the planet. They leave that part out. Because it's God's people. It's okay to kill God's people in the news. You watch it. You watch it. It's okay to kill Jews. I told you that wasn't that big a deal. They were raping women over there. I saw video with my eyes, man. They didn't put babies in ovens. I saw a picture of one that was took out of one. They killed that baby. They put that baby in that oven alive. In front of his parents. But that's okay, because that was God's people, man. That was just them old nasty, running the world Jews that everybody hates. Hate them if you want to. Hate them if you want to. I won't have to worry about you in heaven. Kill Christians here if you want to. Go ahead. Go ahead. Because they were in a way better place, man. All 2.5, 3.5 million of them. They're in a way better place than we are. Kill some more of them, man. Come kill me next. Jesus, I'm ready. I want to go. I know where I'm going. Come get me next. Leave them little children alone. Let them live for a little while. Let them walk in the Lord for a little while. Get to know him. Let him use them. They're young. Leave them alone. And the response from our country, nothing. Churches ain't heard a word. News, don't hear nothing. And the government, I wouldn't trade a bucket of spit for our government. I'd rather have the bucket. That's the honest God's truth. That's how low they are. All of them. Just care about the pocketbook. They've sold us out, y'all. I really believe that. And then another thing that I want to share with you real quick. I was thinking about this morning. Where Jesus was, he had said one time that if you clean, back when he was washing the apostles' feet, he said, if you clean, all you need is to get your feet washed. And he was telling us the way the Christian is to move forward. The book never says you ain't going to sin no more, but it tells you how to deal with it. Peter said, no, you know, I want you to wash my feet. And I ain't going to lie to you, that would be a terrible job. I would hate to have that job, washing people's feet all day. That would be bad. I wouldn't enjoy that at all. That would just be a misery. I wouldn't want to go to work. That ain't something I'd want to do. But, he got down and he washed all their feet. And then I had told a long time ago that these people, you know, they wore sandals. And they were on dirt and sand, rocks. And so a lot of times if you had gotten clean and took your bath, you still might have other things to do before you lay down and go to bed. So your feet might get dirty. during the course of whatever you got to do, your feet would get dusty, dirt. That's how it is with our walk. When we fall, our feet are dirt. And I thought about J.R. in his sermon about the what God gave, the cost of a gift that he gave us.
Hello, everyone.
And that the cost of it. And then I got to thinking that the cost of it, and I always thought the Lord God was sitting in heaven, Jesus, and he just had it made, man. And I love that thought, because that's what he deserved. But now my thought is, and I hate this thought, but I know this is how he works. Now, when I go to him every day and tell him I'm sorry for the things I've done, he's washing my feet. He's washing my feet. I'm saved. But what he's doing is he's cleaning my feet. He's getting that dirt I just walked in today off me. Off my feet. He's a foot washer. My Savior. My Lord. The one I pray to. The one I ask to help me. His job right now in the church age primarily is washing feet. And I hate to say he washes mine on a regular basis. So I never ask nobody to do it. I ask him to do it all the time. Something I would never ask nobody else to do. I have to ask him all the time to do it. So now when I'm asking him to forgive me, in my mind, I'm going to be asking him to wash my feet. Jesus, I'm sorry, I need you to wash my feet again. 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 And the good news about that is that when the Lord forgives, he forgives and forgets. Something a man can't do. Can't do it. You can forgive people. And you can get past anything, but you will never forget it. It will always be there. It will always be there. But when he forgives, he's done with it. So sometimes when you go to him and you say, Lord, I messed up again, I did it again. He says, what did you do? Because you already asked him to forgive you for the other. So he's done put it out of his mind. He forgave it and forgot. So when you go back that next time, you got to tell him what you did. Even if you did it 100 times yesterday. Because every time you asked him, he said, Jesus, please forgive me and help me. Every time you ask him, he wiped my feet clean again. He wiped my feet clean again. And to me, man, I sure hate making him wipe my feet. If that's not an incentive to do better and to tighten up, I think that's why he told me that. I don't want him washing my feet. I don't want him having to clean me up all the time. I don't want him having to worry about that. That shouldn't be what he's doing. He don't deserve that. He deserves way better than that. I shouldn't be putting him through that. Now that's the way I look at it. And that's the better way. That's the better way. And that can't do nothing but help make for a better walk, closer walk. That's what we're hoping for. And we'll close with that. Dear Heavenly Father, we just can't thank you enough for your presence. We can't thank you enough for allowing each and every one of us to gathering your name here this morning, and we will never be able to thank you enough, Lord. We just want to give you all the praise and the honor and the glory you so richly deserve, and we fail to give you that as often as we should, Lord. There's nothing we can say or do, Lord, that would express how we feel about you and how much we love you. But we just hear and pray that us being here is a sign to you that we are yours, Lord. We do believe in you, and we're counting on you, Lord. And it's in your precious name, Jesus, that we pray. Amen. Thank you all. And pray for those people in Nigeria. What a mess.